How's it going, everyone? It is Pangino here, and in this video we'll be covering what I would say are essential steps for any PC featuring an AMD Ryzen CPU to get the outright best performance from that CPU, unlock any and all functionality alongside any new features, and the big one, potentially fix any micro stutters or lower than expected performance you may be experiencing in any of your favorite games. Get Windows activated for a great price with Hookies. Use the links below for Windows 11, Windows 10, or Office. Apply code PAN20 at checkout for an additional 25% off. Secure payment options, including PayPal, are available. Once complete, just paste the key to activate Windows and remove the watermark. Windows 10 keys can also upgrade to Windows 11. Use the links in the description below, and thank you to Hookies for sponsoring. First up is arguably the most important step, and this is often overlooked, and that is to install the latest AMD chipset drivers. These are incredibly important, and if you haven't gone and manually installed these yourself, then Windows will have an older default version installed, which is often going to lead to less than expected performance, potential micro stutters, or if you aren't experiencing any of those issues, it's at least outdated and potentially less secure. To download and install the latest AMD chipset drivers for your system, first of all, take yourself over to Google. There are then two methods that we can obtain the latest chipset drivers depending on your system specs. First of all, for those of you on an AMD Ryzen CPU, but you have an NVIDIA or Intel graphics card, head over to Google and search for AMD chipset drivers. Go to AMD.com's driver and support section, go to Windows 10/11 auto detect drivers, and select download Windows drivers. Once this is downloaded, open it up. It will then automatically detect the operating system and chipset that's needed for your system and get you up and running on it. Now, for those of you that have a Ryzen CPU but are using Radeon integrated graphics or a dedicated Radeon GPU, as long as your AMD GPU is somewhat recent and you have access to the 25.3.1 GPU drivers or higher, if you're not entirely sure, make sure that your GPU drivers are up to date, and if the number matches the one on screen or it's higher, you should be good to go. Navigate to the bottom right to manage updates. The AMD Install Manager should open up. Go to the available software and installed software. Inside of here, you should be able to find the chipset drivers. If there are new chipset drivers available to be installed for your system, just head over to the download icon, install those to your system, and you're then good to go. You can also choose to have AMD automatically keep the software up to date for you by checking this box, and you can also check which version of the chipset drivers you are running at any time under the installed section, and it's just that easy. But if you're using an AMD GPU that doesn't have access to these drivers and it's slightly older, or if you would like to manually download and install the chipset drivers for yourself, instead of using the auto detect option on AMD's website, I instead would recommend heading to Google, searching for AMD chipset drivers, and putting tech power up on the end. Head to the latest AMD Radeon chipset drivers at techpowerup.com. Make sure that your URL matches the one at the top. The top left hand side, you'll be able to download the latest drivers for your system. Select a download mirror. Using the tech power up method is the quickest way to get the overall driver package, which as you can see supports basically all Ryzen CPUs and chipsets, and it takes the guesswork out of trying to find out what chipset and what CPU you are using. The reason I'd recommend using this if you have a Radeon iGPU or dedicated GPU is because if you download the auto detect drivers from AMD, it's going to assume that you're looking to upgrade your GPU drivers and not your chipset drivers. So go with the tech power up option if you're using a Radeon integrated GPU or dedicated GPU, and use the auto detect drivers if you have an NVIDIA GPU or an Intel GPU. Once those are downloaded, simply open up the chipset driver or auto detect that you downloaded. You'll then be given the chipset drivers alongside some optional installs that are available to you. You can choose to remove any of these for any reason if you wish to do so, but in my recommendation, I would have all of these selected, then go to the bottom right and select install. Once your chipset software has been updated, head to the bottom right hand side and select to restart your system. Login as usual, all of your AMD chipset drivers are now up to date. Next up is to stay up to date with Windows updates. Windows 11 has had some performance issues on Ryzen based systems. Thankfully, about 2 months ago, there was a patch that was deployed onto the Windows 11 24H2 major revision update, which is still currently rolling out to some select systems. But thankfully, the Ryzen performance improvement section of that update was actually brought across to Windows 11 23H2, which most of you watching this video are probably still running on, in a quick fix update, which is highly recommended for basically every single one of you watching this video to have installed. Even if you don't see average FPS go up much, many of these updates will improve the 0.1 and 1% low performance, which is arguably more important in games for stability and reducing stutters. For those of you on a Ryzen CPU but you have an NVIDIA GPU, a few quick settings that I would recommend that you look into, especially if you're running the NVIDIA app. Open the NVIDIA app, head over to the settings section. I would recommend switching game filters and photo mode to off. as this currently causes a massive performance reduction in many popular titles. You don't need to have the whole overlay turned off, just the game filters and photo mode. Wouldn't surprise me if Nvidia puts out a fix for this relatively quick, so you can feel free to turn this back on if you really want to use it, but for the best performance possible, leave this turned off. If you still happen to experience lower than expected performance or micro stutters in any of your favorite games after any and all of the steps showcased in this video, a recommendation from me would be to look into uninstalling your GPU drivers and doing a complete fresh install of those utilizing DDU. You can find a very quick and easy to follow along with video guide linked in the description down below. On top of this, my number one recommendation for those of you that can do this is to do a clean Windows install every 6 to 18 months, depending on how on top of things you want to be. Windows installs will naturally become more and more bloated, slow down, have older drivers, newer drivers, conflicting drivers, and just become more troublesome the longer you have it installed. If you thankfully can utilize things like cloud storage or removable storage and you don't have necessary files installed to your system all the time, a clean Windows install will take you about an hour or so to do, re-download your games and be back up and running on a completely fresh system software-wise, fixing practically any software-related performance issue that you could be experiencing. For those of you utilizing a Ryzen CPU with an NVIDIA GPU, if you happen to be utilizing performance monitoring software such as MSI's Afterburner, there may be a small performance bug currently within inside of MSI Afterburner with some of the performance monitoring tools, so look to disable MSI Afterburner or just don't have it open when you're playing some of your favorite games and see if that fixes any potential issues you are currently having. Overall, I think MSI Afterburner is fantastic, but if you are experiencing this performance issue and are now looking for an alternative performance monitoring software, I would highly recommend Googling NVIDIA's FrameView, downloading that, open it up, select where you want the overlay to appear on your screen, boot into your favorite games, and most performance metrics, including PC latency, will then be viewable. I would still recommend MSI Afterburner and RevaTuner Statistic Server performance monitoring, but if you happen to run into this issue, it's worthwhile checking that off just to see if that potentially fixes it. If you are still experiencing micro stutters, especially in first-person shooter games, and you have a relatively decent gaming mouse that supports 1000Hz or above, depending on your CPU and how CPU-bound the game is, in some scenarios, having a super high polling rate mouse can potentially introduce micro stutters. Easiest way to see if this potentially fixes your issue is to lower the polling rate or mouse refresh rate down in the mouse software. I'd recommend jumping all the way down to 500Hz just for now. I wouldn't keep it there, but try 500Hz. If that does seem to fix your issue, you at least know that it's a polling rate related issue. You could then slowly increase the polling rate to see how far you can raise it without introducing that micro stutter if you happen to be experiencing it. For some bonus steps and optimizations that I would recommend that you look into after this video if you're still experiencing any potential micro stuttering issues or would just like to triple check that you are getting the most out of your system across the board, is to update your BIOS to the latest revision. This is incredibly important, especially on AMD Ryzen based systems. Often provide many improvements to 0.1% FPS, average FPS values, necessary security fixes, new features, and I would highly recommend that you update these around about once every 6 or 12 months if you are on an AMD system and are completely confident doing so. Let me know of any other tips or tricks that you may have, and if you're looking for more optimizations, check them out in the description down below or check out one of the two videos on screen, and I'll see you over there.